Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to Rust. A long time no video, but I kind of wanted to do a video about my base. And also I get a lot of people who go, hey Schmuck, I see you playing Rust a lot. What's going on? So this is pretty much it. I enjoy making bases and shooting things at long distances. And it makes me happy. So there you are. I thought I might give you a tour of the triangle base, which is... I didn't watch any tutorials on how to really make any of this stuff. I just kind of did it. So I'm assuming that somebody out there has made a base like this and has a YouTube channel with the video up already, but I kind of did my own thing, and so I kind of just want to do a video about it. The one thing you might notice is this weird gatehouse on the front. It is not perfectly triangular due to terrain... constraints. Actually, I can show you on this side here. You can see where the foundation kind of slopes up in a way. The higher you have to build your foundations, the more difficult it becomes due to kind of terrain swell and drop. So you got to find a place. If you're going to build big, you got to build in a really sort of flat area, which we don't really have. We have this whole peninsula kind of walled off. There's like four of us that live here, so we're pretty well protected. We could do more to protect ourselves, but we just haven't bothered because we haven't had to. You can see on the front here, there's a bit of a weird extra wall, which is just kind of honeycombing vertical triangle pieces and stuff. Because, again, terrain not cooperating, it got to about here and then went, you know what, that's all we're going to do. Because of the height of the foundation. So I had to build another thing up front here to kind of make it look as triangular as possible and correct as possible, because the other side went the correct distance. Also, consequently, this had to kind of come out and around because, well, there was a weird dip in swell in the terrain. You can see here how the foundation kind of went up this way. Yeah, it didn't really make it perfect, but we did the best we could with what we had, and I had a little help from one of the guys named Noobcakes, who kind of like, well, what if we do this? And I'd spent a whole morning just trying to find a place that was going to be good for this. And this is the best I could do. So he helped me out a bit. And yeah, so I'll take you inside and show you some stuff. And kind of tool around. A little bit about what's going on with me lately. I'm, you know, occasionally buying skins for things on Rust. Fucking sick. Sick. My gun as well. Pretty sick. Whoop. Oh no, I've got no arms. Ooh, we've got bullets just hanging around. Neat. Whoa, I didn't know I could turn my head this far backwards. Okay, the more you know. Good times. Anyway, carrying on. Since the last time I did a video, I moved. My brother and I sold the house, and now I'm in a different location. I got a new swing arm for my mic, so my mic is closer to my mouth. Probably hope it sounds better. And feature number one is shotgun traps. So we've got a lot of vertical honeycombing in this base. And yeah, so... if you're smart, you can hide traps all over the place, and if you're also smart, you don't have to hide them. So, you know, please come knock, knock, knocking on my front door. Well, we're shotgun traps. When I first built the base, there was a tool cabinet right here. If you're not familiar with the game, that doesn't mean anything to you. But basically, it gives you a sphere of permission where to build, and if you're not on the permission list, then you don't get to build here. We got us a flame turret, like, right up front, so that's fun. And now we are actually inside the triangle itself. How much light is in here? Well, we got enough. I think that's enough light. So, like I said, the first, there's a lot of vertical, what do you call vertical honeycombing, as in there are no horizontal floors. There are these, supports, which you need to kind of build up as high as I have. And in every corner there is... there is a turret, so if anybody breaks in, they're in for a long day. There's a shotgun trap around a couple corners, stuff like that. And so yeah, that's basically what's going on. Floor number one and two or as collectively I refer to this as kind of the first floor. That is what's going on with that. Whoop, hello! And inside we have more death, which I will show you. And this is the inner courtyard of the triangle. Ordinarily I would have honeycombing on the inside as well, but I didn't build it as big as I used to. I built a couple more that were way bigger than this. And so you've got a instead of this being an open hallway, this would be like a row of honeycombing with another hallway kind of just outside. So you have to blow up a lot of shit before you can go get in here. I am post-dating this video. This video will not be published until after the forced wipe, which is a monthly thing that happens in Rust because it's still in beta, I think. So, beverage. So basically, once a month, the first Thursday of every month, this game gets completely wiped and you start again. Which sounds bad, but actually it's kind of a challenge and kind of fun. So, if that sounds interesting to you, you know, check it out. What you have to do, and you'll notice that this is all ceilinged off, is what you have to do is these things, once you've mapped out your foundations, have to get placed down. You cannot place furnaces under a roofed environment. You can place these little water catchers under here as much as you want. There are much larger ones that you can build, but I decided to just kind of go with a series of smaller ones. But I have some campfires under here, refinery, and six furnaces. So the industrial foundry is up and running. Did I not turn this one on? Did I not put wood in this one? Oh, well. Let's do that then. I've got a little wood. And there we go, it's off burning wood. So now we're off and producing. To get upstairs, there's only one way, and that's through this inner core. You've been greeted by many traps. This, for the uninitiated and don't know about this game, I deliberately put up this chain link gate with a code lock on it because the auto turret here can shoot through that with impunity, no problem. Anybody breaking in is going to get fucking blown away. And that's sort of the first layer of protection. Once they've destroyed that, if they haven't destroyed these walls, then they have to contend with the shotgun trap and the flame turret. If they have come in through like the back, then they still kind of have to deal with the turret because it can flip around. And then there's this cargo netting, which you use to get up. The problem with that being that there's a hurricane of fiery death waiting for you. So step number one, stay alive. Step number two, already have building privilege, which you don't have. So if you come up here and all of these flame turrets and these flame turrets and these flame turrets, basically, they're all going to nuke these cargo nets, they're going to burn them up, and you can't climb up, and so you're kind of defeated. That's the plan. It's not a perfect plan, but it is a plan. There are more traps up here, just kind of waiting for fools to come upstairs. More flame traps around cargo netting. I was using this as an access point to get down to the second floor. So the first and second floor are all vertical honeycombing. The third and fourth floor are all vertical honeycombing. Like you see here, this is actually the third and fourth floor underneath, and there are more turrets down there. Can we get a view? There's a view. So there's one down there. There's one down there. You're basically below. If you can get up onto the third and fourth floor, you're still fucked, because you're still going to be greeted by a hail of gunfire and death. I could seal this back up, but I'm not going to, because I like to use it as free access, and it kind of gives somebody breaking in some hope, because they're going to get toasted by flame turrets anyway. And yeah, in the corners we have the tool cabinets themselves and the turrets. If I was really paranoid, I would be walling these away. There are more tool cabinets downstairs in various locations in the honeycombing. To find them, you'd have to hit exactly the right spot and then fucking hope. But with these here as high up as they are, they kind of provide the ideal amount of coverage. If I really, really, really wanted to, I could move them in out here into the extreme corners and then push my kind of range even further. But I haven't bothered to do that. I've got sort of, you know, most of my stuff is in here. I haven't really acquired much on this this wipe to really necessitate a giant dump room, although you can easily do that with this base. Various tools, and we got my I'll change into my hillbilly gear. Yeehaw! We're gonna do the rest of this in hillbilly mode. With my revolver with a silencer on it. Makes me laugh. Yeah, so this is the front door area. This kind of got built in with the gatehouse, because we didn't really have much of a choice. Again, cargo netting with a flame turret. You can, in fact, open this up and open fire onto people below. That's where we came in. More flame turrets, so you're still locked in a cage with an angry flame device. I think I placed this one close enough that it can also shoot at anybody in the cage. And if that's the case, it's kind of preemptively destroying this cargo net. And then I have for sure placed that guy in such a way that you can't actually jump up here. You can jump back up onto that post there, but then you have to try and get through the door, and then yada yada yada. And I should probably put another, like, turret or something in here. I think, or maybe two. I could have one facing this way and one facing that way. Probably. There's a lot I could have done with these traps that I haven't currently done, because there's no pressure to do it. Everybody on the map is either not on my level, or our level, scrubs, or just a pack of whiny cunts, quite frankly. They're all a bunch of snifflers. Oh, we can't build good things. Like, it's because you're not trying. To go further upstairs, this is the seventh floor altogether. Again, more traps. We got a couple flame turrets here set up to burn the netting should that necessity arise. Some more auto turrets in various locations, kind of spread out. It's got kind of, I put up for sight lines, so if anybody's coming up there, they're gonna get rat-a-tat-tatted, or coming down, they're gonna get rat-a-tat-tatted. Another one over here with the sight lines of any kind of cross, like animal crossing, going from upstairs to downstairs, they're gonna get fucking got. And there's another one over there, just kind of backing up things. So that's pretty much what's up. Last night I did an extra additional thing, which is put the roof on this so you can't see straight down. I may put double doors in all of these just to be a dick. I probably will do that. This was a sniper tower that I kind of set up with just the need, the desire for a sniper tower, really. And this is built up as high as I can make it go before the stability really kicks out. You can see here this is 8% and 6% stable. That's 27%, which is pretty good. And I'm thinking about replacing all these half walls with shop fronts, which you, if you're familiar with the game, again, makes sense. If you're not familiar with the game, basically it's like a bulletproof glass section of wall, so you can see out and they can see in, kinda, but they can't shoot you. So I'm thinking about doing that. That appeals to me. So that might be an update I do. And yeah, I just kind of had this and put doorways in and put turrets in there, so anybody coming through is gonna get, again, wrecked. And then I put up these towers. Actually, I'll show you. This one actually is complete-ish. As complete as I feel like it should be. These were, again, just kind of afterthoughts last night. And I don't have any traps in here yet. You can stop off here and kind of look around and shoot things. Oh, yeah. And, yeah, this is actually vertical honeycombing this section right here. It's just an extension of the corner. So that's all that is. And then if we get up here, rather than wrap these out-angled roof section, so this is supposed to be a roof, but I angle them outwards because then they can do this and look down on stuff. And then I just kind of put windows over here, so we could put up some shutters and you're kind of horizontally protected from anything. I don't think, like, 11% stable is not enough to really hang anything up here, so I don't think roofing, again, is going to be an option. I didn't try it. I just didn't push my luck. So, yeah. That's pretty much the base in basic. If anybody's got any questions, holler at a boy, hatch your boy down in the comment section as I try and pick off that horse from long distance with my shoot gun. This is not going to make it. Too hard. Ooh. Hello? Knock, knock. Oh, that was pretty close if you saw the tracer on that one. That was pretty close. Shotguns are not accurate over distance, but man, if you take a slug in the brain, you are effed. It is hilarious. So yeah, that's pretty much what I've done to further impress upon anybody who's not familiar with the game. All of this is armored. So what that means is it is the highest level of building material. It will take you, I think it's 3 rockets to get through any single panel. So to put things in perspective, there is a layer, this being the outer wall. On the walls in this are thick. So you got your this wall, and then you've got a panel going that way, and a panel going this way. And then to make things all nice and solid, these are all paneled as well, horizontally. So you've got outer wall, inner wall, inner wall, another plate of outer wall. And so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 just to get in. That's just getting in. And that's on the thinnest part of the wall. If you do that, congratulations, you're into the into the bottom floor. Grats. There is no, on this server, there is no twig rating. Again, if you don't know what that is, don't really worry about that. But we like the admin. By the way, we're playing on Bullseye. Bullseye Gaming? Yeah, Bullseye 5 times. That's what we're playing on right now, so everybody jump on that. There are 4 other players right now. Yesterday we had like 6 or 8. And yeah, so we've got 5 times gather, kits you can get. If you want some bonus materials, you can buy a VIP kit. We wipe once a month, forced wiped only. Blueprint wipe when forced only, so that's good. Blueprints are a new thing. You'll have to do some reading and do some investigation on that. If you want some cool shit and hilarious kind of commentary, go watch some videos by Shadowfrax. He is an amusing cat. Kind of want to shoot that horse just to show off for the stream, but I'm not going to be able to hit him. If I do hit him, you'll hear like a kind of a sound, like an impact. Elevating, elevating. Oh, I got him! Run, horse! Anyway, that's been me in my hillbilly outfit with my Oxum's gas station hat. And, yeah, enjoy yourself. And, maybe if you feel like you'd come play some Rust. Oh, my God, I'm almost done 20 minutes on here. So, how's the wife and kids? That's pretty much it. Yeah, you guys have fun. Holla at your boy. And, you're not going to see this until, like, October 6th. Or not October 6th. It's, November... What day? It will be... November 3rd. So November 2nd is when the wipe will happen. I think. Pretty sure. First Thursday? Yes, first Thursday of the month. So you guys won't see this till November. Because, quite frankly, I'm not an idiot. And I don't need anybody coming in and raiding my base. And I never really build the same base twice, although I'm a fan of this particular design. So I have built it, actually. Oh, got him again. I have built it multiple times. It's just so much darn fun. Oh. It's probably going to take a lot of hits. Putting the silencer on that dampens your... brings down your damage potential. So I'm probably going to have to hit him quite a few times. Also, the drift on the bullets at that distance is ridiculous. But I kind of want to get the kill. So... Oh, I don't have any more bullets. God damn it. Well... Bringing up the shotgun. That's not going to work, is it? Not going to work. Alright, well, it was a bold experiment, and thank you so much for tuning in. if you feel like you want to see more videos like this. Oh, one more feature. Goddamn, I forgot to tell you. So you notice that there's smoke drifting up all the way from the furnaces. But once you build up this high, no more smoke. It just doesn't go higher than this. So by building it as high as I have, no one can tell what you're doing inside. No one has a clue. Even my campfire that's on the second floor, second floor. My campfire here that's in the loot area doesn't give off enough smoke. I've got a campfire right here. It just doesn't give off enough smoke to be seen through the roof. So, yeah, it's pretty much a monolithic nightmare. And sure, it's raidable. Everything in Rust is raidable, but no one's ever really done it successfully. My hiccups are no fun. You crazy kids, enjoy yourselves. It's been over 20 minutes since I noticed I was probably going to cut it off before 20 minutes. And just keep talking and talking and talking. And goodbye!